gentlemen, boys and girls. Welcome to another day in the trenches. Day 63, to be exact. And yeah, if you guys could smell me right now, I smell good, I tell you what. I'll tell you that for free. Got some Dior Sauvage on. Been wanting to buy that bad boy for a while now. And I decided to buy it, and I bought it, and it smells good. I smell good, it's great. So, yeah, open the garage, turn the Jeep on, get the ball rolling here with a beautiful song that I chose for you guys today.
Our song is to slam the screen doors, sneaking out, hey, tapping on your window, when we're on the phone, and you don't read the song.
Good song choice, hey? I knew it was. All right, we're off to the gym, by the way. If you're new here, if you're wondering where we were driving to, it is to the gym. I say that in every video, and I will continue to say it in every video, because I will continue to drive to the gym every single day. So yeah. Anyways, yesterday, okay, I was thinking of an analogy I could use for how I always like to train to failure, and I wanted to like figure out a good like example, you know? So I figured one out. So anytime I kind of think about like the human body and stuff, and like you know, how it works, how it functions, a good kind of analogy is comparing your body to like a vehicle, okay? If you want to drive around like a shitty little fucking Kia Soul, green Kia Soul to be specific, okay? Then you want to give your body fucking regular gas, fucking no oil changes, you know, whatever. Just treat it like shit. But if you want to drive a nice supercar, a nice Lamborghini, you know, you want to be a nice vehicle, you got to give it premium fuel, nice synthetic oil, you know, just real clean stuff. That's like the food, you know, chicken and rice is like premium fuel. But then that brings me to the training to failure point, okay? Imagine, first off, I'm not a car guy at all, okay? Like, I'm really, and I'm not like a big fan, like, oh, I can't wait for this vehicle to like come out, like whatever. Like, I'm not a huge car guy, but like, let's just say the fastest car in the world can go 200 miles an hour, okay? Let's just say. Now, you want to make it so that vehicle can go even faster than 200 miles an hour. And what are you probably gonna have to do to figure that out? You're probably gonna have to push the vehicle to 200 miles an hour to see what's wrong with the engine, to figure out what can I do to fix this engine to make it so it can go even quicker. So we have to push the engine to its limit to figure out what the problem is. Because if you're only pushing 100, 150 miles an hour every time, you're never gonna be able to pinpoint what the problem is. Same thing with training to failure. If you're never training to failure, how do you know what your max is? How do you know how hard you're able to push yourself every single day if you never pushed yourself to your limit before? So then once you figure out what your limit is, that limit of like today, you know, should be tomorrow's minimum. So yesterday's maximum is today's minimum, and now you find your new maximum. Okay, you gotta push your limit every single day, just a little bit, not too much, but you always gotta push the limit every day. You always gotta do something that sucks every single day to see improvement, because that is how you improve. Well, that car talk brought me all the way to the gym here. I didn't really do a whole lot of talking because I spent most of the ride singing our song. Good stuff. Anyways, we're at the red zone, the dead zone, the kill zone, the war zone, whatever you want to call it, we're at the gym, okay? So, let's get to work, shall we? All right, handstand conditioning, You don't wanna fall in love. Seeing your mind walking out the county market in a stop. You're not throwing your finger 1 second, it's a blessing. Dead there. All right, one bar. Damn it. All right, another one more. Okay, cool, yeah, nice. Oh. Alright, good stuff. Alright, Japanese handstands. My second set. Meet me out back if you like. That sounds boom. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 6 to heaven. Okay. always gotta take a fucking step. All right, let's go to vault, real vault, fun.
K-Tech vault, 2 handsprings, 5 round-offs. Handspring number 1. Solid warm up. Okay, handspring number 2.
Long neck, got so beer, and float my heart.
Okay, time for the real vaults. The round off stuff. Round off number 1.
Nice.
That was alright. The first one. I wasn't bad. My arm was hella wide, so I got no pop. It just kind of went over and flipped. It didn't really go up and flip, you know? Height. I need height. I need a pop. So let's do that. Okay, round off number 2. Yeah, height was better. Rotation was worse. Gotta bring them, you know, together. Lots of height, lots of rotation. Cause I kind of just landed like that. I wanna miss my feet. So much height and rotation that I can't even hit my feet on the floor. All right, round number 3. Okay, never mind. It felt better than it looked. Felt really good. But still, all right. It can always be better. So yeah, my legs hurt. So if this one's really good, then we'll stop at 4. The reward system. All right, round off number 4. Yeah, we're just gonna finish on that. As I was walking back, I was like, oh, let's just do a double twist and call it the last one. My legs hurt. Not hurt, they're like sore. It's not pain, it's like a soreness. It's very, very stiffness. Let's go to landings. That double twist is, I don't know what to say, all right? It was bad. It was a bad double twist. We're gonna go do landings. All right, time for landings. I actually put the beatboard on this side this time because I just feel like it shouldn't take me this long, but I just kind of realized that every time I do landings, I'm always facing like that way and then flipping like this way. So let's switch it up to throw off my game, okay? Face that way. See if we can mess me up. Yep, let's get started. Deadly. That was good. Took the back tuck half turn 3 or 4 tries and the front tuck 2 tries. All right, 1 half first try. That's weird. Usually it's the opposite of that. But yeah, good stuff. Let's go do some shoulder physio. All right, we're starting different here. So usually I start with bungee and whatever. Someone showed me a new exercise and I think it's a good starter one to like warm it up. So you just go heels against the wall, back against the wall, shoulders against the wall, everything up against the wall. And just down and up. No weights or anything. So we're gonna start with this. I think it'll be like a good warm-up one. I don't really know how many to do, so I'll do it till it kinda like burns. Because that's my favorite amount to do. Oh, well, that's good. Wow. That's insane. Once it starts to get like hard, your shoulders and elbows are like forcefully trying to like push away. So you have to like really focus on like keeping it against the wall like the whole time. Oh, it's good stuff. All right, here's another new one. I usually do this one every Wednesday before I start training. It's a good one. You don't go for max stretch either way. You just do like half reps the whole time. So make sure your body's parallel when you start. So kind of my shoulders straight in front. Shoulders are kind of leveled with the weight. You just go up, down. I only got a 10-pound weight. I just go quick, as many as I can. It's a good one because it teaches you to, you know, catch it there before it hits the bottom. You don't want it to hit. You want to catch it right before it stops. Go up here and catch it right before it like goes past. So you can do like fast twitch reps, you know? So obviously here is a max stretch, but like there would be max stretch. So I want to stop way before that. Then I want to stop kind of straight up. Whereas this is where I'd normally go, but I want to stop right there. Catch it. But at no point are you supposed to slow down. You just kind of keep going until you literally just can't go. Don't like start going slow, always fast. And then you just start doing half reps. Either way, it just has to keep going quickly the whole time. Don't like start slowing down, just fast. All right, and always after 2 sets of strength stuff, I like to just do a stretch in between. So this one, up and down for a minute. Nice.
Hi. I don't know if I said this at the beginning, but we're switching up the whole shoulder thing to a bunch of different exercises. Probably won't like keep it this way. It's just to kind of like change it up for a different feeling for once.
Yeah. For this one, we're gonna do two different sets of it. The one same against the wall like I always do.
One of them's gonna be really lightweight, lots of reps, quickly doing reps, and then we're gonna do one with like 25 pound and do like three really slow reps. So we're gonna start with the 25 pound.
We don't have a 25. Well, it's all the way over there. I'm not grabbing it. So we're grabbing a 30 and I'll just do a squat.
We're just going for like three reps. All right, and then right away with the 10 pound. So it's like kinda like one thing, but two separate things.
No.
I didn't hurt anything, it just burns. See, and since I normally do this with like a 20 pounder, 20 pound weight, whatever, I have the 10 for that one. So I can go into the full stretch and move relatively quick back up from the max stretch because it is a very light weight to me. So the odds of it tearing are next to none when it is, it has to feel like light. But I still hit max stretch. I feel it pull slowly up a little bit and then I go to max. Whereas if I had the 20 pound, I go all the way to max stretch. I feel it pull up to about here and then I go quick. But with the lighter weight, I feel the max stretch and I only go up just a little, so the muscles kind of contracted in just a bit and then I go fast because it's light. So yeah, like the harder and the heavier the weight, the more you should kind of bring your muscle back into place before you do any sort of fast twitch.
Oh, right. Everyone's favorite segment. Naturally, how would it not be? You know, swing to handstands.
Let's start off with 15 swing to handstands here. All in a row. Zoom you in, probably angle you up. Oh yeah, zoom you out slightly so it's a little, yeah,
there we go, money.
Okay, nice. One set down, one more to go. All right, five pirouettes, five swing handstands, crazy. Okay, let's get started. Shall we? Oh, I should do ASMRs. I'm gonna change up the channel. We're gonna do ASMRs from now on. No more gymnastics, no more vlogging. I'll just like hit stuff. I'm just kidding. It's just me rambling. I'm trying to, can't remember the word, where you push stuff back, you know, where you, why can't I? Stalling, the fuck, why can't I? Yeah, that was the word I was looking for, is stalling. I'm just stalling. And I wasn't stalling, trying to find the word stalling to stall more, but that's pretty much what I'm doing right now by explaining it to you. Let's just go do the swings. Okay, we're done. That's the end of first training. See you guys in second training. All right, welcome back to second training. Today we're on P-bars. Hudson's currently on the bars.
Hey, man.
Hey, what's up? So yeah, let's warm up and let's get started, shall we? I've decided to go with half routines. I just finished warming up for like 15 minutes and yeah, not doing full routine today. Today is not it for a full routine. But now because I didn't do it today, I have to do a full routine on Friday. So we'll just do like three half routines today and then that's good for P-bars. So yeah, let's get started. Half routine number one. Bad. All right, aptitude number two.
Ashton's the best.
Oh yeah, Hamda was deadly. Oh, it's all right. Some good, some bad. Sometimes good, sometimes maybe shit.
Sometimes maybe good, sometimes maybe shit.
After number three.
All right, that's good. Pretty good. No need to force anymore. Stitch ones are a little off today. I made the first one. Made one of every skill. So let's go to high bar.
Okay, ladies, gentlemen, boys, girls, time for high bar. Let's get started.
Felt bar.
Good morning, chat.
What was with the laugh? Like.
Yep.
Thank you.
Yeah, chat. Skibbity toilet chat. Chat. That was definitely not for her to chat.
Oh, the bar is so slippery, man.
Yeah, that was good though.
Go. Yeah.
Nice. He is strong with the arms.
Go. Come on. Yeah.
I should have just opened my mouth and stayed.
All right, that's enough high bar. High bar was really good, actually. I didn't do a lot of turns, but all the turns were good. So, yeah, time for pommel. As always, three pommel routines, and then we're golden for the day. Got gum in my mouth again to try and throw me off here. And yeah, let's get started. Routine number one. Alright, routine number three. All right, midway through the Subato, my right toe cramped up. I didn't flex it though. You can watch it back if you want. I held that point the whole time and fuck, did it hurt. It was a clean routine. I don't know, see scissor, it was a clean routine. Yeah, good stuff.
Would you guys like to do the outro again? So you. Okay guys, that's the end of video. Hopefully you enjoyed the full video. If you did, glad to hear that. And if you watched the full video, comment the word.
Keppy.
Spell it.
P-R-E-P-P-Y.
Bye, love you.